Brian,
How are you?
I bow down. I am such a huge fan. So thank you for your time this morning. So much to get to. But we go way, way back, my friend. Let me talk to you.
I can guess because I know you're in Toronto. Does it have something to do with that?
It has something to do with a little show called Ragtime. And I covered that show way back when, meeting you, meeting that cast. Brian, that had to have changed your life. Hello?
It absolutely did. As a matter of fact, when I was doing the show, I was known up till then as Brian Mitchell. And I thought, I had a feeling before we started the show, I thought this show was going to change my life. I really had this feeling before we did our first workshop of it. And I thought, Brian Mitchell's not a very good stage name, you know. And it's a good regular name, but as a stage name, and I was going to change my name completely. And I thought, you know what, let me just put Stokes in my name, which is my actual middle name. Right. So, and I'll have everybody call me Stokes. So call me Stokes, like all my other friends do now too. So it's great, but it did change my life, absolutely.
Yeah, and your relationship with Audra McDonald, and oh my God, on and on, right? What a memory. It was great because we were able to have all these shows in Toronto that launched so many careers so many years ago. But let's talk about this wonderful special that you have, because you have such a fabulous relationship and longtime personal connection with the Tabernacle Choir. Tell me a little bit about that, because this special, you know, it's beautiful, but it gives us unprecedented coverage of behind the scenes. It's wow. Amazing. What amazing show it is.
Yeah, thank you. That's why I was so happy to be a part of it. I do have a great kind of relationship with them. I performed with them on a number of different occasions. I think the first time was probably 15, you know, years ago, maybe more. And I did their Christmas special in 2009. When was aired. And I've performed with them since a number of times. I think we share a spirit in a sense, you know, because there's this feeling there that the music has this wonderful, healing, joyful spirit that can be transmitted while you're singing it to other people. And I think you'll feel this all over this particular telecast. It was one of the things that was so much fun. Normally, the telecast is an hour telecast. It's PBS is one of their top, usually their top holiday show of the season.
Right.
This season, because of it's the 20th anniversary, we got to do a 2-hour special. And because of that, I got to give a backstage tour. You got to see this 21,000 seat auditorium, the front of it, the lobby, but without people in it. But you also get to see it with people in it because you have 20 years of highlights from these shows that have been done that have just been filling people with joy and happiness and the holiday spirit.
Yeah. And you talk about, you know, music is a connection because Brian, you know, with COVID, of course, Broadway, everything shut the world. You get out there on your balcony and you sing, you know, and I can't even imagine, like, look, I'm thinking about it now and I want to tear up. You really brought so much joy to people. And I know the reactions from people who listen to your, like, what does that mean to you as a performer, as a person, you know, as a human being?
I feel very blessed. I feel very grateful to not only be able to do that, but to have been given the opportunity to do this. Now, I've been doing this for 40 years. That's all I've ever done is perform, you know. And from the very beginning, is I was performing professionally before I got out of high school, and I just went from one professional job to another. And I feel very, very blessed. And to singing out the window when that happened, because of COVID, you know, it was my way of showing gratitude for all the essential workers of New York City. That's what we did. We would clap for everybody, you know, at 7 o'clock every night. And then one day, spontaneously, I just started singing out the window and it stopped everybody on the street. And then and they had clapped after that. And then the next day, more people were there and more people. And then finally, it went viral and people all over the world were seeing it. And there were hundreds and hundreds of people that were gathered every night. I began to think this was kind of performative. You know, I feel funny now because I was doing it as an act of gratitude for all of the essential workers who were putting their lives on the line. And you hit something kind of on the head. And this is kind of what I feel from this telecast as well. A neighbor from across the street that I'd never met before stopped me as I was going to a store. He said, "Brian Stokes Mitchell?" I said, "Yes." He said, "You don't know me. I'm your neighbor across the street. I come out every night to applaud the essential workers, but I also come out to hear you sing. I bring my wife and my two sons. We come out and we listen to you every night. It's the one time in my day I feel joy."
Yeah.
I
yeah.
thought, oh, right. I forgot the power that we can have, the power of art, really. Yes. Art has to reconnect us to our happy place, our joy place. And that's why I'm so happy to be a part of this particular telecast.
Yeah, it is absolutely beautiful. And Brian, before I wrap, I mean, I'm such a Broadway person. I was actually just got back from New York last night. The first time I've been in a plane for two years. And I walked around Broadway. I unfortunately didn't get to see anything this trip, but I will next time. But I have to mention Tick, Tick, Boom. Oh my God. I have watched the scene Sunday maybe 400 times, and every time I watch it, I'm just bursting to tears to see all of you together in that one scene. Please tell me in a minute before we wrap what it was like to be there and be with all these your cohorts, your guards, and after COVID, and oh my goodness, wow.
It was amazing. It was the first time that we had been assembled, many of us, and had seen each other live since the COVID had started. What's particularly magical about that scene is there were usually no more than two people on screen being shot at the same time. That was assembled later on by a brilliant editor. And the same thing happens actually in this telecast, where we actually reassemble the choir and the orchestra, hundreds and hundreds of people together. Right. I'm just so thankful for technology that it allows us to do things like Tick, Tick, Boom, and like this wonderful concert with the Tabernacle Choir.
Yeah, well, listen, you're just such a delight and joy, and have just brought so much happiness to my life over the last 40 odd years. So thank you from the bottom of my heart. This special is absolutely stunning. And please come back to Toronto. You should come to the stage here. We're back up. We're back up. I just saw Jesus Christ Superstar last week, so I'm so excited.
I'm so happy to hear that. May you continue to thrive. May theater thrive. And may everybody, all your watchers and everybody part of your show thrive as well. And just let's continue to love one another as best
Absolutely.
As we can.
Thank you, Brian. And happy holidays to you and your family. Appreciate your time. Okay.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.